Hi everyone, it's Kevin, and today I'm going to show you the recent updates to Adobe Media Encoder CC 2018. The January release of Media Encoder has a couple of major features that you should know about. The first of which is variable frame rate support in H.264 and H.265 containers. So if you don't have a very powerful computer, you'll want to transcode or create proxies for H.264 or H.265 footage so that you have a smoother editing experience. This new feature allows you to do just that. Next up is support for more video footage formats, in particular, the Arri Alexa mini camera in MXF Arri RAW format. HEVC codec footage is now supported, wrapped in a .mov container, which will be very useful for people shooting with iPhones or DJI Phantom drones. There are a few features worth reviewing from the October release of Adobe Media Encoder, the first of which are related to publishing in social media platforms directly from Adobe Media Encoder, channel support for YouTube and Vimeo. There is now the ability to publish videos to specific YouTube or Vimeo channels directly from Media Encoder. Next is playlist support for YouTube. You can also specify a playlist when uploading to YouTube. Another great feature is the ability to create custom thumbnails for YouTube. You can now choose a custom thumbnail for your YouTube videos. Select a frame from the source video or choose an external graphic in order to use it as a custom thumbnail. There is now page support for Facebook. Using Adobe Media Encoder, you can specify a page from the list of all available pages from your Facebook account. Enhanced titling for social media can now be used to add custom titles to your videos directly from Adobe Media Encoder. Next up is support for animated GIFs on macOS. This gives Mac users the ability to export an animated GIF format directly from Media Encoder. This feature was available only on Windows in the previous versions. Missing item notification is the feature that shows you a notification for any missing items. Sources and outputs with missing items show a warning icon in the queue. This allows you to correct any issues before starting to encode, preventing any wasted efforts while encoding. Next are preset improvements. The match source presets have been enhanced and changed with this edition of Adobe Media Encoder. There are three new match source presets for H.264 that automatically choose the best bit rate based on the frame size and frame rate of the source. The presets offer to match the source of your export and encode with high, medium, or low bit rates. Presets for H.264 have been streamlined so that you can quickly locate the right preset for your needs. Redundant and outdated system presets for the H.264 exporter have been removed, with some of the presets changed and enhanced for the highest quality export with the proper settings. Time Tuner offers a new feature to skip slates. This allows you to ignore any slates when adjusting the duration of only the program's contents. Finally, a new UI font, Adobe Clean, is now a font for Adobe Media Encoder's user interface, the standard display font for all digital video applications in Creative Cloud. So those are the new features. Thank you so much for watching. Hey guys, we love making these videos and we can't wait to make even more. So if you like the video, give it the thumbs up. Or even better, subscribe.